Obviously, good win for the program. You know, it was a little bit of an asterisk not having Caleb there. Such a phenomenal player, NBA player. But you know, that's the way the ball bounces sometimes. And hopefully, he'll get healthy. I don't know the extent of his injury and what is exactly wrong with him. But he was in a boot that you never like to see. So I'll say a prayer for him. Hopefully, he can get back on the floor quickly because phenomenal player. But it was very, it's a very good win for us because I think we're playing better, and that to me is the most important thing. Is as long as we keep improving, the winning will take care of itself. Tonight was a good team effort. You know, JoJo obviously scored the ball well, but we had a lot of subs, a lot of freshmen out there throughout the game. That if they didn't understand the rivalry when they listened to that chant at the beginning of the game, they understand it now. So hopefully they can, you know, continue to bring home a lot of victories for the Rebels in their tenure.
Did you feel coming after the Boise State game that you guys are right there in that court, that helped come into tonight?
You know, in retrospect, yeah, I think having a game of that magnitude with the crowd and the noise. Just a few days ago, didn't shell shock these guys, you know, and they were still very successful in that game. They didn't come out with the win, but they did a lot of good things in Boise. So I do feel like that was something that gave us a little bit of an advantage to handling the environment. You know, you got to give Eric credit. He's really built this program up in a short amount of time, and I mean, it was sold out. It was loud. So my hat's off to Eric and his staff. They're doing a great job.
What did you think Jovan gave you guys tonight?
Besides the scoring, you said
everything.
Oh well, you know he's been in the rivalry now. This is his third time playing in this game, so he understands what it means. I mean, I thought that he played with some passion. I thought they played with passion too. I thought it was a very spirited game both ways. But Jovan was, he was JoJo tonight, you know, he made shots and, you know, some of them, too many circus shots, but we're going to work on keeping him in his box, but he can make those shots. And that's the thing about it, that, you know, it's a rare thing where you got a guy who can shot fake and get to the line like that, but he's got a good level of concentration and he plays through it. So, but I thought defensively he was really, really, really good as well. So I thought all the guys played well tonight. I thought it was a good team win. We got a lot of good bench play that came in a tough environment and performed well.
When you find out that Caleb Hart is not playing, does that change anything that you guys do before a game?
Changed a lot. You know, it changed a lot because he's such a phenomenal player. He's, you know, he's candidate for MVP of the conference, and we had a lot of different coverages that we had planned that we had to kind of alter at the last moment. And I thought the guys did a good job adjusting at late notice and adjusting to, you know, not playing with Brandon in there and having to play Shakur and Lulu together for a stretch of time. And so there was some good things that came out. Growth came from other guys when there were some hiccups with the other guys.
And every time Wolfpack made a run, you answered. And this is something that's been happening a lot more recently. What does it say about the mindset of this team?
Well, that they're understanding how to compete. They're understanding that the game is a game of ebbs and flows and runs. And you're not going to be successful unless you can sustain runs, both defensively and offensively. And then also, you know, combat them when they're thrown at you. And that's what our guys are doing. You know, but let's keep it in perspective. It was one game. We're going to play Reno again. We've got a really good team coming in here, Wyoming, at home with Wyoming on Saturday. And we need our fans there. It's going to be an environment, you know, that can help us win that game. We've got to keep building this thing from the ground up. And I shouldn't say from the ground up, but we got to keep building from where we are now and move it forward.
Thanks, Mark. After last season, just what does this mean to get this win here?
It means a lot, especially considering the fact they haven't lost on their home court probably over a year, I think. So, I mean, I just wanted to get the guys up for this game. And, I mean, they did a great job of responding. You know, I met with all the guys for the game and just let them know, like, you know, this is going to be a battle, you know, because coach has been on me about making sure everyone is on the same page going into this game. So, we did a great job of responding.
Did you feel like the guys played this game differently? Did you feel that intensity from the entire team for the entire 40 minutes?
I wouldn't say we approached it differently. I just think we approached it with more energy, you know. I mean, we always have a game plan, you know, coming in. But the effort we displayed tonight was probably our best all year. And we just got to continue to build on this. You know, it was tough coming off the loss from Boise. You know, a lot of guys were still talking about it. But coach let us know it's a quick turnaround and we got to forget about it, you know. And we did a great job moving on.
31 points for you is a career high. What was working for you? What got into you? Like, what was going right for you out there?
Just, you know, I mean, I owe it to my teammates, you know. I mean, they were collapsing on defense, you know, on our bigs, and it opened and spaced the floor. You know, and our guards, we did a great job of getting into the paint, you know, and guys were finding, and I was able to create off of that.
You had your shot early. Did you feel early on that the confidence was there for you and it was going to be maybe not 31 points, but it'd be a good night for you?
I mean, well, I'm always confident, you know, and sometimes I'm probably a little too confident, but I mean, you know, I'm always play that way. But I mean, it's just a good night, you know, and just got to continue to build from it.
What does this win mean as far as moving forward?
You know, it means that we can play with anyone in this league, you know. I mean, a lot of guys think we're underdogs sometimes when we play these type of teams, but it's even keel to me, you know. I mean, I don't think anyone's better than us. That's how we're going to approach every game. That's how we've been doing.
I know you don't like questions about last year, but how satisfying is it for you? Because I know that you remember what happened here last year. How satisfying is it for you to come in and get this win?
You was there last year when they ran the score up both times. I mean, it feels good to get one, you know what I mean? I'm just happy for our guys, you know, especially playing in that environment. You know, they've never played in this type of environment. Well, they did last game, but I mean, to get a win in that type of environment is big for us going forward, so.
To do with Brandon and foul trouble so much in the second half, what does that say about how your team was able to rally together?
Well, you know, B's our centerpiece, you know, they had a game plan to, you know, collapse on him when he got the ball, and B did a great job of just working. I mean, he was a monster on the boards and creating extra opportunities for us, so. Even if he's not getting 30, you know, he's always finding a way to affect the game. So I'm really proud of him for that.
On that, late in the game, when Nevada had that possession, and they had the loose ball, and you dove and you got the timeout. What happened on that play? What was going through your mind? And how important was that, was getting that possession for you guys?
I mean, you never know what could happen, you know. I mean, that possession could have been, you know, the difference in the game if we didn't get it. So I was just doing whatever I could to get an extra possession for us.
Thanks, Judge. Congratulations.